Hello students, previously we had learnt about nouns and we had also done some exercises. Now we'll be moving on to page number 14. You just have to look at the screen. I will be explaining to you. The first question is, identify the nouns in the sentences given below and write their genders in the blanks given. That means you have to find out the nouns and you have to write which gender they are, okay? Now, gender means male, female. There are some more also over here. I will be explaining to you, okay? So, the first sentence is, my uncle and aunt live in a village. Now, you know, uncle means male. So, we will write over here masculine. Aunt means it is a female. So, we will write over here feminine. Now, village. See, village is not a girl and village is not a boy also. So, here you will be writing neuter. Second one, this man is a farmer. Now, man is already masculine, right? Now, farmer can be a man and farmer can be a woman also. So, we have to write common. Common, that means it can be male, it can be female also. Third one, his wife is a good cook. Now, wife, we know wife is feminine, okay? And cook also can be male or female. So, that will be common noun. Next one, the artist has two sons. Now, you know the meaning of artist, right? A person who does paintings and all that. Artist can be a female, it can be a male also. So, we will write common. Sons. Now, son means male. So, we will write masculine. Next one. My friend has a computer. Now, see, friend can be a girl and friend can be a boy also. So, we will be writing common. Now, computer is not a girl, it is not a boy. So, we will write neuter. How we had done for village? See, village is not a girl, not a boy. So, we had written neuter. Next one, the bridegroom is my cousin. Meaning of bridegroom is a boy who is going to get married, okay? Bridegroom, so masculine, it is a boy. Cousin. Now, cousin we say in Hindi sometimes cousin bhai, cousin behen. That is wrong, okay? We have to say just cousin. Cousin can be a male, can be a female. That's why we have written common. Next one. This baby is our neighbor's child. Now, if you see over here, baby, neighbor and child. All of these are common, common, common. Why common? Because baby can be baby boy or a baby girl. It can be a male and it can be a female also. Neighbor, what do we mean by neighbor? Neighbor means padosi. Neighbor can be male, neighbor can be female. Child also can be male and it can be female. So, common, common, common. Last one. The flowers in the vase are from our garden. Now, see over here, flowers, vase, garden. This is not a boy, this is not a girl, right? So, for flowers, vase and garden, we have written neuter, neuter and neuter, okay? Now, we will move on to page number 15. Question number 2. Rewrite the following sentences using the opposite gender of the underlined word. What do you mean by opposite gender? I'll give you one simple example. Opposite of boy is girl. Opposite of man is woman. So, in the same way, we will start with the first one. These hens live in my farm. Which is the underlined word over here? Hens. So, you will rewrite this sentence and you will change this word. So, you have to know the opposite of hen. The opposite of hen is cock. But here, since we have S, we have to put S over here. These hens live in my farm. So the answer will be, these cocks live in my farm. Next one. The horse ran very fast. Now you know the meaning of horse, right? The opposite of horse is mare, M-A-R-E. The mare ran very fast. Third one. The prince went on a journey. Prince means we say Rajkumar, correct? The son of a king. So the answer will be, the princess went on a journey. See over here, Rajkumar, and this is Rajkumari, right? There are 12 geese in this pond. Now what do you mean by geese? Geese is like a kind of duck, okay, batak what we say. Now G-E-E-S-E means it is plural. Singular will be goose, G-O-O-S-E. There are 12 geese in this pond. So the answer will be, there are 12 ganders in this pond. The next one is, the lady is very kind. Now we know this is a very simple word. The opposite of lady is man. So the man is very kind. Next one, my father is a good artist. Now you know the opposite of father, right? It will be mother. My mother is a good artist. Next one. A stag walked into my garden this morning. Now what is the meaning of stag? Stag is like a deer, okay? So the opposite of stag is D-O-E. We pronounce it as doe. A doe walked into my garden this morning. So we'll move on to page number 17. Read this question carefully, okay? Write C for countable nouns and UC for uncountable nouns. First of all, you should know what is the meaning of countable nouns. Any noun that you can count is called a countable noun. Any noun that you cannot count is called uncountable noun, okay? Make plurals of the countable nouns. That means the nouns which you can count, you have to make it plural. The first one is lady. Now you see, this is a countable noun. We can count. So it will be L-A-D-I-E-S, ladies, plural. And here we will be writing C, that is countable. Next one is air. Now we know that we cannot count air. So the answer will be UC, uncountable. The next one is light. Now even light we cannot count, right? But yes, we can count bulbs, we can count the tube lights, but we cannot count light. So it will be uncountable. Next one is doll. Now we all can count a doll, right? Or we can count dolls. So the plural is D-O-L-L-S, dolls. And this will be countable noun. Next will be teacher. We can count teachers, right? One teacher, two teachers, three teachers. So it is a countable noun. Next one is fence. Now you know what is a fence, right? You must have seen in the school, we have fences around the school. So you can count that. Next is oxygen. Now you know what is oxygen, right? We breathe in oxygen. Same as air, we cannot count oxygen. So it is uncountable. Next one is music. Now see, music, you may get confused because we say that I'm having one song in my mobile, I'm having 10 songs in my mobile. But music is something else, okay? Music is uncountable. We cannot count music. Same way for mud, mitti, we cannot count it, so it will be uncountable. Second last one is mountain. The plural of mountain will be mountains. We can count mountains, right? One mountain, two mountains, three mountains. So it is a countable noun. Last we have news. In this word, we already have S at the end. Now you should know that this word is not plural and it is not singular also. And we cannot count news, so it will be uncountable. Now we'll move to the next exercise. Use of to change the following as shown. First one, the sun's rays. Now you know what this is called? This is called an apostrophe. The sun's rays. Now if I'll say in Hindi, what it will become? Suraj ke kirne. So you have to remove this apostrophe and you have to put off. Okay. The rays of the sun. See, the last word will come first and this middle word will come last. The rays of the sun. Okay. The rays of the sun. Next one. The flower's petals. Now again you have to do the same thing. The petals of the flower. See here. The petals of the flower. Next one. The boy's surprise. The surprise of the boy. See here. The surprise of the boy. Next one. The children's toys. The toys of the children. Next one. The ocean's depth. The depth of the ocean. Next one. The river's bed. Now this bed does not mean palang, okay? Where we sleep, not that one. Whenever we talk about river's bed, it means the ending part of the river, down, okay? So the answer will be the bed of the river. Okay, this is very simple. Now we will move on to page number 18. Exercise number 2. Use apostrophe S to change the following as shown. Now you see question number 1 and see question number 2. What we had done here, we have to do the opposite of that in question number 2. Here we had apostrophe S, we had to remove and we had to put off. In question number 2, we have to use apostrophe S. That means we have to remove the word off. Okay. So first one, the taste of the soup. Now here it will again become opposite. The last word will come in middle and this word will come last. See over here, the soup's taste. And see over here, the soup's taste. So this last word came over here, right? The soup's taste. Don't forget to put apostrophe S. The feathers of the eagle. Now see again, eagle is last word. This will come over here. The eagle's feathers. Okay. Next one. The dress of the baby. Now again the last word will come over here. The baby's dress. Next one is the color of the leaves. Now again this last word will come over here. Now here you have to pay attention because this is already plural, right? So in the answer you will put the leaves color. In any word, if it is a plural and it has an S, you have to put apostrophe after the S, okay? See, L-E-A-V-E-S apostrophe. The leaves color. Next one, the friends of the girl. Now again, this last word will come over here. The girl's friends. Next one, The stem of the plant. Now again, this last word will come over here. The plant's stem. Okay. Now the only thing you have to pay attention over here is this kind of sentence. Whenever you have any plural word which is ending in S, what you have to remember is apostrophe will come after S. Okay. Moving on to the last question. Fill in the blanks to get correct sentences. First one, this garbage dump attracts a lot of. Now here, why have we written flies, F-L-I-E-S? Let's see the options, okay? First one is F-L-Y-S, which is a wrong spelling. This is not the plural of fly, okay? So the correct answer will be F-L-I-E-S. Here apostrophe S is a wrong answer. Next one. The flies come from the nearby bushes. Now here, see this first spelling, it is a wrong one. The correct spelling is B-U-S-H-E-S. We will not use apostrophe S over here. Next one. People mostly throw overripe tomatoes. Now even here you have to pay attention to the spelling. See, this option is correct. This option spelling is okay, but the answer is wrong because we will not write apostrophe S, and even this is wrong. Even this spelling is wrong. T-O-E-S. So these two are completely wrong. The answer will be T-O-M-A-T-O-E-S, tomatoes. Next one. They also throw dirty boxes. Now this is a very simple answer. You know the plural of box will be boxes, X-E-S. Next one. The cleaners are angry at the garbage spread around. Cleaner means a person who does the cleaning work. So the cleaners are angry means gusse mein hai. The cleaners, it is plural. So this is a wrong answer over here. And this is also a wrong answer. Okay. Moving on to the next one. They are angrier at the neighborhood's dirty habits. Angrier means what? Aur bhi zyada gusse mein hai. They are angrier at the neighborhood's dirty habits. Now why apostrophe S over here? Because it is the same example what we had done earlier. Neighborhood's dirty habits. The dirty habits of the neighborhood. Okay. So here apostrophe S is correct answer. They cannot get rid of the swarm. Now over here, this spelling is wrong. This spelling is correct, but because we are having apostrophe S, it is a wrong answer. It will be swarm of flies. Okay. S-W-A-R-M. Next one. Sprays will not help them. Now to kill the flies we use sprays, right? Different kinds of sprays. So that's why you have to make it plural over here. Because we don't have just one kind of spray. We have many kinds of sprays. Next one. Knives will not kill the flies. Okay, here I have not given the option because this is a different kind of plural. K-N-I-F-E is one knife. When we make it plural, it will be K-N-I-V-E-S, knives. And now the last one. What would help is clean habits of the people of the neighborhood. Now here just see F and C J. It is almost same, right? Dirty habits of the neighborhood. So this will change to neighborhoods, dirty habits. In the same way, clean habits of the neighborhood. Neighborhoods, clean habits. Okay, now because clean habits is over here, we will not use apostrophe S. What would help is clean habits, habits of the people of the neighborhood. If you do not understand anything, you can go back to that part of the video and you can watch it again. Okay, thank you.